Contour operations in SOLIDWORKS CAM have a Leadin tab where we can control how and where the tool starts into the cut. This program cuts around the perimeter, then roughs the slot, and finishes the slot. It would be more economical if that first tool started in the front of the part where the tool changes occur for cutting the slot. In the lead-in tab, we can control the type of lead-in, the type of lead-out, and where the tool enters the cut. It selects the longest edge by default, and we can position it anywhere along that edge. The start to the end. Or the midpoint. To start on another edge, we simply select another edge. In this case, I want to start on the front edge, and the midpoint is fine. Here's the simulation. Begin in the front and cut around the perimeter, then rough the slot and finish the slot. Z-level operations in SOLIDWORKS CAM can be challenging to set up. These three faces were selected to create a multi-surface feature, and a Z-level operation was created to machine it. As you can see, the operation doesn't cut the entire surface. There are options in the Z-level operation parameters to adjust that, but it can be tricky. Here's an easy technique that works in many cases. Instead of selecting the part geometry, create a surface by copying those faces. Then extend that surface. When defining the multi-surface feature, select the extended surface. The Z-level operation is created using the extended surface. It machines everything we want. I'll suppress the first Z-level operation and run the simulation. Cut around the perimeter, rough the slot, finish the slot, and then cut the angled faces with the Z-level operation. Thank you.